Hi Aries, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and today we'll be doing your August read, a general August read to see what energies are coming towards you and how you can use these energies to have a wonderful month ahead. And these are general collective readings, will not resonate with all of you. Take what works for you, leave the rest. So my angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Aries and send them the messages they need to hear the most for August. Thank you. So Aries, let's begin your reading and welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here. And Aries, if you're new here, we welcome you as well. To join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. All right, Aries, Six of Pentacles. Oh, okay, good. I like your August energy. Okay, and your secret message. All right, Aries. Oh, bottom of my deck, I have the Five of Swords, Aries. Either you're going to be very competitive in something, whatever you're trying to do, or maybe somebody is coming to fight with you. Because I do see a little bit of conflict in your recent past as well. Somebody who you were in competition with, or you were fighting for a position, or maybe you were just competing to be the best at your work, I don't know. But whatever said and done, I do see currently you in a very good space. You finally achieved that balance where whatever you're putting in, you're getting back in return. It's an equal balance, give and take. This could be in work, could be in business. In the past, you may have felt that there's too much of competition around you and you were not sure whether you could succeed or not. But now I see you kind of coming into a place of saying, all right, yes, there are many players in the field, but I'm as good. Whatever I have to offer, I also get my return back. Because see now in August, I see you coming into this mode of temperance. Temperance is like, again, same as Six of Pentacles actually. Very healing, balanced, equal give and take. You pour into me, I pour into you, whether it's love, whether it's business, money, anything, friendships. So a lot of harmony coming into your life in August, Aries. So before I start clarifying these cards, Aries, as usual, we have to do our Ganesha Oracle card, right? Let's see what Lord Ganesha is going to bless you with for the month of August. So Lord Ganesha, for my Aries gang, please, blessing, guidance, advice, or a message. Enlightenment. All right, Aries, you get the card of enlightenment. Yes, maybe you've been struggling with something till now, but now you've reached that place where you know the tricks of the trade. You're enlightened. You know what to do to get the equal amount of return back. Whether this is in a love situation, maybe people used to take you for granted. Now you know how much to, you know, what to do, how to have equal give and take. You are an enlightened soul now, but it hasn't come easy. It has come after a lot of conflict, lot of battles that have been. Okay, so Aries, let's start your reading, okay? Currently, I see you in a pretty good position. Six of Pentacles. Why is that, Spirit? Why is Aries in the Six of Pentacles energy? Or maybe that's the way you want things now. You want to only accept what you... Oh, okay. No, I'm wrong. All right. Aries, I think you're doing a lot of work. I don't know what you're doing, but I think you're working like almost with both hands. Right? You are juggling so many things right now to bring your pentacles back into a certain place where you are almost on the verge of succeeding into that Four of Pentacles and the Ten of Pentacles energy. I think you're stopping at nothing, Aries. You're stopping at nothing. You have a focus. You want stability, you want your coins, you want growth, and you want to retire in peace. And right now you feel, okay, this is my time to work. I'm going to work day and night. I'm going to do multiple things if needed so that I can achieve this as soon as possible. You have a goal and you're stopping at nothing. This is your current energy. All right, so in the recent past, what happened, Spirit, with the Five of Wands? Five of Wands. Oh, there was a lot of competition around you, and people thought they, even though I think you, a lot of people were fighting you or trying to put you down or hamper your progress, Aries, I think you shut the door on all these people who were bringing conflict to your life. You shut the door on a lot of people in your past. You took a little time to yourself. You shut the door, literally, like put a board outside your door to say, do not disturb. And you took a little time of reflection and you decided, I'm not going to deal with all these kind of people who are going to slow me down, because I have a goal, and that goal is to be the best version of myself for me. You wanted abundance, growth, fertility, stability in your life, right? So, and that you've done by yourself. I think all these other people only created a lot of chaos and conflict around you. But the day you shut that door on them, you took back your power. It came after a little bit of healing, but you finally realized that everything lies within. I don't need all these people in my life to give me what I need, right? I'm not dependent or codependent or anything. I told you, I think in one of my previous videos, Aries, a very wise man, my uncle, once told me, when you want something, don't ask another person for it, because he's also getting, or he or she is also getting their abundance from source. So instead of taking the long route, why don't you ask source straight? You have the capacity of having everything that you want, because source is for everyone, right? That whatever you may want to call it, the universe, your angels, your guides, gods, whatever, they are there available for anyone who's going to pray and maybe, you know, work hard and request for what they want. So this is what Aries has done. They said, I'm not asking anyone who's going to create conflict. I am shutting down the door. I'm taking some time out to heal. And I have now decided, this is what you decided for yourself, I'm going to become the best version of myself for me. And yes, and you've worked hard for it, Aries, as well. I still see you in this energy of saying, universe, send me work and I'll do my best, kind of that kind of an energy. And you are doing a fantastic job. You're juggling day and night with both hands, I see, collecting your coins, because you have a goal of reaching this position by yourself. So what's going to happen in August, Spirit, now for Aries? Temperance. What's Temperance going to bring for my Aries gang? Okay, all right. One more. One more. Aries, I think you are going to be leaving a lot of your troubles behind in August. Anything that has been toxic in your life, or that you've been stressing about, or not being able to, you know, rest or sleep, maybe not being able to get things off the ground in work or whatever, I think the formula for success, I think you've figured out now. Each time you are faced with any of this kind of a scenario, I think my Aries has learned to leave conflicts behind and sail away. This has become like, I think, an Aries formula. I'm going to shut down any toxic behavior. I'm not going to allow anyone to slow me down. Anybody creates conflict, I'm going to move away and go and find some solitude time for myself. Right? You feel the minute you are in your zone and you can connect, like I said, to the universe or spirit, you go into healing. So this is what I think you're going to be doing in August as well, because the way your progress is there are people who are going to be not very happy. The devil will emerge in a lot of people, because they're stressed out seeing you being so peaceful and balanced and maybe moving away from them. There could be some people around you who would want you stressed out. But I don't think, Aries, you've learned your lesson. Yes, you are. Yeah, you're moving towards your happiness now. I think this is a cup of love you'll be giving to yourself, some new beginning where all your wishes are coming true, maybe moving towards new horizons, new love, new place, new. Everything is new for you in August. There's something new coming for you. Let me know in the comments in August, okay? What new is going to happen for you in August? And yes, and this is coming from spirit. This is not coming with the help of anybody. Earlier there was conflict, now I see devil people. Everybody's pissed out and irritated that how does Aries do it? They go into solitude, they are by themselves, they rest up a little bit and then they spring back into action. How are they doing this? Just give me a second, my battery needs to be... Okay, so let's see. What should Aries hold on to? King of Pentacles, my spirit. What's this King of Pentacles? Spirit saying now you can hold on to that feeling that you have cracked the code to make money. Simple as that. The luck is on your side. Wheel of fortune is in your favor. And don't ever worry. We're never going to let you down because the money is going to pour in now, Aries. You have cracked the code with the universe straight. It's like the treasury of the universe. The keys with my Aries now. So Spirit says, don't worry. The luck is on your side. Wheel of fortune is on your side. And you will always have enough now. More than enough. Because you trusted. You trusted and you worked hard for it. So what should Aries let go of, Spirit? Spirit is saying, Aries, yes, you've invested many times before and those investments may not have paid off and you may be a little disappointed at your previous investments. But maybe that time you hadn't cracked that. You didn't have the key that time. So if you're still kind of grieving over past mistakes or past things which haven't... fruitified for you, don't worry about that because now in the future, see what's coming for you. Knight of Cups and the Ace of Cups. So if this is a love situation, there is a new love coming where love is going to overflow. And if this is not a love situation, this is just self-care and happiness and new beginnings. Leave this in the past. Don't ponder too much about things which haven't fruitified in your life. It's time now to look forward to all the new beginnings. Everything is screaming at me at new. New love, new beginnings. I had a Page of Cups as well. New. Everything is new. So, what can become Aries' biggest blockage, Spirit? Hierophant. Why will that become a blockage, Spirit, for Aries? One more. Aries, Spirit is saying, I think you've been a bit controlled because of people's expectations of you in the past. Maybe you've been living by the rules in the past, people's norms, society's expectations of you in the past. I think Spirit is saying, if you continue to do so, it'll keep you blocked. You're an Aries. You're like this child on, sitting naked on a bare back of a horse, right? So this is the kind of youth, vitality and youthfulness an Aries has. So don't let anything, any rules become any blockage to you. You have to now live free. Walk away from all these people who have restricted you in any way. You have a lot of passion, then lots of new beginnings coming for you. We want you to be prepared and ready to take on travel, business, projects, creative projects, whatever you need to do without feeling restrained by rules now. No more rules for Aries. That's what Spirit is saying. All right. You must have done something really good, Aries. You seem to be a favorite nowadays. All right. So how do people see Aries, Spirit, in... August, 10 of Swords. They see that you've completed an old chapter of your life maybe, which was very painful, where it may have been very burdening to you. Maybe you've been through some battle, some fight with people. You've been hurt and betrayed. No, but they also see that you're not like sitting around moping or crying any longer. You've kind of put this to a rest and you're ready now to charge ahead. They see that you've come out, you're ending a cycle. Like this is like 10-10. Both these 10s is what how people see you. And they see you that you've successfully fled from, you know, this past thing and you're fleeing into your future and looking gorgeous doing it. Looking single, abundant, beautiful, you have your pentacles, everything is in order for you after this horrific, horrific ending. You lost everything. I mean, this is your close people, your friends, family who know your inner stories. They are feeling that, oh my God, look at my Aries. They went through all this and now look at the sprite in their step. And they're racing ahead once again. And look at the way they're looking now. They've regained their power. They've regained their strength. That they were looking gorgeous. And they have everything that they need by themselves. That's exactly what you did here. You stopped waiting for other people to provide for you, Aries. You took the bull by its horns. And people are noticing that about you. So what is Spirit's secret message to you? Knight of Wands, yes, that's another card for positive, you know, action and moving ahead in a very youthful spirit and energy. Knight of Wands spirit? Yes, yes, yes. Okay. One more. Oh. Okay, Aries, first of all, spirit says lots of offers coming towards you. Keep a little childlike energy if possible. And I know you've been battered, bruised and everything. All the tens are over. Now it's the time for the ones. Okay, the Ace of Swords. Now this is like a new life beginning. You have to approach it also with the eyes of a child now. That excitement, that youth, that, you know, I want to rush here and do this and do that and try new things. Spirit is saying this cycle of yours is going to be a very healing and balanced one for you. There's going to be a lot of healing and balance in this new cycle of yours. Please, if possible, can you take your blindfold and see what we're offering you? I know fear, you have a lot of fear and you don't want to, you've kind of closed your chest at the moment because you've been hurt in the past, but the universe is, this is their secret message to you, Aries, I'm not saying anything. They're saying, we need you to now use this sword and cut this blindfold off and throw these swords away. Start with the one now, not with the two of indecision, I'm not sure, I'm tired, I don't trust. We don't want two for you, we want one sword. We want you to approach life now in childlike, youthful energy. Race ahead with your new passions, your new projects, whatever you need to do. And this time, we promise you, now you're an enlightened soul. Lord Ganesha is saying, we promise you this one is going to be healing and balanced. And this card, Aries, has come out for you twice, not once. The Temperance is in your August energy. That was the card there. And Spirit's secret message to you as well. Now, this is a beautiful card. This is the angels literally, you know, healing you, bringing things back into balance for you. Okay? So, yes, that's a beautiful message for August. And I shall see you now on Friday, hopefully. Touch wood. Love and light. Take care. Namaste.